Hello students, in today's class we are going to continue the last part of molecular orbital theory, where we are going to discuss the molecular orbital diagram of carbon nitrogen molecule and that of oxygen molecule. Now here you can see carbon molecule C2. The electronic configuration of a carbon atom, atomic number of carbon is 6, and the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. So totally there are 6 electrons. But in carbon molecule C2, there are 12 electrons, and the electronic configuration of a C2 molecule is therefore written as, right? Before going to the electronic configuration, we will see how the molecular orbital diagram can be written. Here I will write one carbon atom which is present on left hand side, and the electronic configuration you can see here, this is 1s2, this is 2s2, and this is 2p2. In 2p2, one electron is present in px orbital, another electron is present in 2py orbital, right? Let's write the another carbon atom on the right hand side, carbon. Again same thing, two electrons are present in 1s orbital, two electrons are present in 2s orbital, and two electrons are present in 2p orbital, which are singly occupied. Fine. Now when bonding molecular orbital takes place, so here I write it as sigma 1s2, and we can see here two electrons are present in BMO, that stands for bonding molecular orbital, okay, and two electrons are present in antibonding molecular orbital, which is called as sigma star 1s2. I write it as anti bonding molecular orbital. Is it clear? It means that from these two and these two, two are occupied in bonding molecular orbital and two are occupied in anti bonding molecular orbital. And the same thing happens when the 2s atomic orbitals of each carbon atom are involved in bonding. So here I write it as two electrons, can you see, and this is sigma 2s2, which are again called as bonding molecular orbital, right? From these four I am speaking, okay, from these two and these two, two are present in bonding molecular orbital and the remaining two are present in antibonding molecular orbital, which is written as sigma star 2s2. Fine. And next comes with respect to 2px and 2py from LHS and 2px, 2py from RHS. Totally there are 4 electrons. So these 2 electrons and these 2 electrons. Totally there are 4 electrons. How these are filled? Initially, first is filled here. Then second is filled in 2py orbital. Why? Because we know that according to Hund's rule, pairing up of electron takes place unless and until all the available orbitals are completely half of filled, right? So two electrons are filled now, remaining two electrons are going to fill with pairing here. So these are 2px and that of 2py. We should remember that 2px and 2py orbitals are having same energy and symmetry, provided that when 2px and 2py are involved, there is a formation of a pi bond. Is it clear, students? And now let us come to the electronic configuration. The remaining part will be above as it is in the molecular orbital diagram. So this compromises of sigma 2pz, and this will be antibonding molecular orbital. So this part is antibonding molecular orbital, which are pi star 2px and pi star 2py, and the above one will be sigma star 2pz. It is mandatory for you students to write the complete molecular orbital diagram, provided that filling up of electron takes place to all those molecular orbitals in which electrons are accompanied. Now, the molecular diagram has been completed. Now let us write the electronic configuration with the C2 molecule. Initially we have filled sigma 1s2, then sigma star 1s2, then sigma 2s2 and sigma star 2s2, and at the last pi 2px2 and pi 2py2. Or you can write in other manner, that is compromising of K and K, which is nothing but this part, sigma 1s2 and sigma star 1s2, and the remaining part is found to be same. And if you see the bond order, and I have told you in the previous class how to calculate this bond order. So here in the square box you can see the bond order has been calculated. It is half of the difference between the electrons present in bonding molecular orbital and antibonding molecular orbital, right? So here 8 electrons are present in bonding molecular orbital. So wherever I have written BMO, that you have to consider, right? So this is BMO, I have written here 2 electrons. So again here BMO 2 electrons, and again these, which are nothing but bonding molecular orbitals, right? So totally there are 8 electrons. And from these 8 electrons you have to subtract 4 electrons which are present in antibonding molecular orbitals. So which are those antibonding molecular orbitals? Here ABMO I have written, and here this is also ABMO, that is antibonding molecular orbitals, right? And if you simplify, you will get the answer as 2. It means bond order in C2 molecule is 2. You can see here the bond order of C2 molecule is 2, and thus C2 should had been diamagnetic, okay? And it is of course diamagnetic because none of the molecular orbitals are having any unpaired electrons. So therefore C2 molecule is diamagnetic in nature. The diamagnetic C2 molecules have indeed been detected in vapor phase. It means that C2 molecule is present in vapor phase. And it is important to note that the double bond in C2 molecule consists of both pi bonds, because of the presence of the 4 electrons in 2 pi molecular orbitals. Which are those 2 pi molecular orbitals? Pi 2px and pi 2py. And in most of the other molecules, a double bond is made up of sigma bond and a pi bond. So thus this also we can see that in C2 molecule there consists of sigma bond as well as a pi bond. And in a similar fashion, the bonding in nitrogen molecule can also be discussed in the next slide. Now let's write the molecular orbital diagram of a nitrogen molecule. Now here there is a completely plane surface, right? And now I will tell you how to calculate the bond order in the case of nitrogen molecule and how to write the electronic configuration of nitrogen molecule, okay, in a simple short manner, right? In most of the competitive exams and all, you'll be coming across such questions, okay? If they ask calculate the bond order in nitrogen molecule, then it is not necessary for you people to write molecular orbital diagram and all, okay? So let's start writing now. So we know that nitrogen is having atomic number 7, right? And the electronic configuration, if you see, 1s2, then followed by 2s2, and then followed by 2p3, right? So total number of electrons are here 7 here, okay? Total number of electrons present in a nitrogen atom are 7. But when I speak with respect to nitrogen molecule, the total number of electrons will be now 14 electrons, okay? Now these 14 electrons are supposed to be written in the molecular orbital diagram, right? So initially now what I can do is I write here 14 electrons in a systematic manner. Can you see now? So I'll write here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, सिक्स सेवन एट नाइन टेन इलेवन ट्वेल्व थर्टीन एंड फोर्टीन ओवर. नाउ आई हैव रिटन दीज इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन सच ए वे सच दैट इट कैन बी ईजी टू रिमेंबर. फाइन. नाउ आई विल राइट दी ऑर्बिटल्स इन वेयर दीज इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर प्रेजेंट. सो दिस बिकम्स सिग्मा वन एस टू. दिस इज सिग्मा स्टार वन एस टू. दिस इज सिग्मा टू एस टू. दिस इज सिग्मा स्टार टू एस टू. दिस इज पाई टू पी एक्स. दिस इज पाई टू पी वाई. एंड दिस इज सिग्मा टू पी जेड. इज इट क्लियर? एंड द रिमेनिंग आर प्रेजेंट एज इट इज हियर ओनली. दैट विल बी एम टी. ओके. सो करेस्पॉन्ड्स टू हियर पाई स्टार टू पी एक्स, पाई स्टार टू पी वाई, एंड अबव विल बी सिग्मा स्टार टू पी जेड. ओके. These will be empty, but we have to draw in the molecular orbital diagram because nitrogen is having only 14 electrons. So we are supposed to write only the 14 electrons, right? Now in these electrons, whatever I have written so far, now none of the molecular orbitals are having what, unpaired electrons. From this I can conclude that nitrogen molecule is diamagnetic in nature. Nitrogen molecule is diamagnetic. Diamagnetic in nature. And now when it comes to electronic configuration, just you have to write this part, which is that whatever I have written right now here up to here should be written. So the first comes sigma 1s2 comma sigma star 1s2 comma sigma 2s2 sigma star 2s2 then pi 2px2 and I will write equal to because their energy is the same, then pi 2py2 then comes comma sigma 2pz2. So 14 electrons are over. So this is the electronic configuration of a nitrogen molecule. And coming to bond order, so bond order is nothing but the difference bonding molecular orbital minus antibonding molecular orbital by 2. Now for your inference, the number of electrons present in bonding molecular orbital, so these are 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. So in bonding molecular orbitals there are 10 electrons minus antibonding molecular orbitals. Antibonding here there are 2 3 4. So 10 minus 4 by 2 it comes to be 6 by 2 and the answer is 3. It means the bond order in nitrogen molecule is 3. Is it clear, students? I hope you got this point. Now we shall represent the next example by taking oxygen molecule. But before going to study the molecular orbital diagram of oxygen molecule, we have to learn one important concept, right? So that concept is explained in this slide. I hope that you will pay attention. Now here the diagrams are there. You can see in the bottom B2, C2 and N2. Okay, what I say that up to 14 electrons and below, it means below 14 electrons. Okay, so here I have written as B2, C2 and N2. Okay, up to 14 electrons you can see that this pi, which is that pi, it is 2px, pi 2px and pi 2py. Their energy is lower than that of what the sigma 2pz. So first we have to write this part, and then we have to write above sigma 2pz. It has been experimentally determined that sigma 2pz is having more energy up to what 14 electrons. We have to follow this rule. Above 14 electrons, it means after nitrogen molecule, if at all we are going for oxygen molecule and that of fluorine molecule or that of neon molecule Ne2, there we should note that this part. Can you see now? The sigma 2pz is having a lower energy when compared with that of pi 2px and pi 2py. So this is a very important concept you have to always remember. Is it clear, students? Now we shall discuss the molecular orbital diagram of oxygen molecule. Oxygen molecule O2 and the electronic configuration of oxygen is 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Why? Because atomic number of oxygen is 8, and here you can see 8 electrons are there in each of the oxygen atoms. Therefore, in oxygen molecule there are 16 electrons. Fine. In oxygen molecule there are 16 electrons. Now let us see that how we can write the orbital diagram. So as I have already told you, we have to write now 18 electrons, and provided that we should remember that sigma 2pz is having a lower energy. This concept we have to remember. Fine. So 16 electrons are there. So I'll be writing now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 electrons. Is it clear now? Now we should recall that how these electrons are present in these different orbitals. So 1 and 2 are present in sigma 1s2, 3 and 4 are present in sigma star 1s2, 5 and 6 are present in sigma 2s2, 7 and 8 electrons are present in sigma star 2s2, 9 and 10 are present in sigma 2pz. Now here 11 and 12, 13 and 14, these are according to what? Hund's rule, right? So this comes to be pi 2px and this is pi 2py, right? And the above here 15 and 16, 15 is present in one molecular orbital and 16 is present in another molecular orbital, and this comes to be pi star 2px and this is pi star 2py, and the last one, antibonding molecular orbital, will be sigma star 2pz, which will not be having any electrons over there. Is it clear, students? And now we should remember that these 15 and 16 are having each one electron. So therefore oxygen molecule is paramagnetic in nature. Is it clear, students? Now fine. Now let us come to the previous slide where we are going to write the electronic configuration of O2 molecule. So I have written here O2 sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, sigma 2pz2. I hope you can see that. Okay, I have come up to here sigma 2pz2. Okay, this part, okay, this has been completed. Now sigma 2pz2, after that you can see pi 2px2 equal to that of pi 2py2. So that is present here. Pi 2px2 equal to that of what? I should write here 2. I forgot here. Okay. Pi 2px2 and pi 2py2. Then comes the antibonding. Okay, you can see here star mark is written here, and these are having one electron, pi star 2px1, pi star 2py1. So this is pi star 2px1 and pi star 2py1. So this what is present in antibonding molecular orbital, right? Or you can write what k and k and the remaining part. This k and k represents this, which is that sigma 1s2 and sigma star 1s2. Is it clear, students? And now, from the electronic configuration of O2 molecule, it is clear that 10 electrons are present in bonding molecular orbitals. So remember that 10 electrons are present in bonding molecular orbitals, and 6 electrons are present in antibonding molecular orbitals. And hence we can say that bond order is nothing but 10 minus 6 by 2, and the answer is found to be. So in oxygen molecule, atoms are held by a double bond. Atoms are held by what? A double bond. Because the bond order is what? 2. Atoms are held by double bond. Moreover, it may be noted that it contains 2 unpaired electrons, as I have already told you, which are present in pi star 2px and pi star 2py molecular orbitals. So therefore, O2 molecule should be paramagnetic. And a prediction that corresponds to experimental observation. It means O2 molecule is having pi bond, and apart from that, it is showing paramagnetic in nature. Is it clear, students? Now let us discuss the last part of this chemical bonding chapter, that is hydrogen bonding. So nitrogen, oxygen and fluorine are highly electronegative elements. We know that when we move from left to right in the periodic table, size goes on decreases, and because of which the electronegativity goes on increases. When these atoms are attached to a hydrogen atom to form a covalent bond, the electrons of the covalent bond are shifted towards the more electronegative atom. You can see the diagram here, which has been represented, right? So I say that when hydrogen is forming a bond with an electronegative element such as F, the covalent bond that is present between hydrogen and fluorine, the electrons are shifted towards more electronegative element. And this partially positively charged hydrogen atom forms a bond with the other more electronegative atom, right? So I have shown here, this is the covalent bond. Because of electronegativity of a fluorine atom, fluorine bears a partial negative charge, so I call it as delta minus, right? And hydrogen develops a partial positive charge. This is one molecule. And the other molecule, you can see that the same representation is done, delta minus and here delta plus, right? Now the fluoride or the fluorine atom, which is having partial negative charge, it is going to interact with the hydrogen atom of another molecule bearing partial positive charge. So this is a dotted line. So this dotted line indicates what? A hydrogen bond. Whereas the complete dash line that is present between hydrogen and fluorine is called as covalent bond, right? So therefore, this bond is known as hydrogen bond, and it is very important to know that it is weaker than covalent bond. For example, in HF molecule, the hydrogen bond exists between hydrogen atom of one molecule and a fluorine atom of another molecule as seen. Right? Hydrogen bond acts as a bridge between two atoms, which holds one atom by covalent bond and the other by hydrogen bond. Hydrogen bond is represented by dotted line, whereas a solid line represents the covalent bond. Thus, we can define hydrogen bond in such a manner. Just go through this. Hydrogen bond can be defined as attractive force which binds the hydrogen atom of one molecule with the electronegative atom, which can be fluorine, oxygen or nitrogen, of another molecule. Now let us understand the cause of formation of a hydrogen bond. When a hydrogen is bonded to a strongly electronegative element X, it can be fluorine or nitrogen or oxygen, the electron pair shared between the two atoms moves far away from the hydrogen atom. If I write it as here H bond F, right, the shared electron pair will move far from the hydrogen because the other atom is more electronegative. As a result, the hydrogen atom becomes highly electropositive with respect to the other atom X, which can be fluorine or nitrogen or oxygen. Since there is displacement of electrons towards X, that is the electronegative atom, the hydrogen acquires partial positive charge, that is called as delta plus, while the X attain partial negative charge, which is delta minus. The delta is nothing but small, okay, that small we call it as what, a delta. This results in the formation of a polar molecule having electrostatic force of attraction. So now we can say that this hydrogen fluoride is a polar molecule because of electronegativity difference between hydrogen and that of electronegative atom fluorine, which can be represented as HX. So you can see this bond here, okay, which is covalent bond. Hydrogen has developed partial positive charge and the halogen has developed partial negative charge. This is one molecule. And if you see this second molecule here, the atom bearing negative charge, partial negative charge of one molecule, is going to interact with the hydrogen atom of another molecule of HX, right? And this magnitude of hydrogen bonding depends upon the physical state of the compound, physical state, whether it can be solid or liquid or gaseous, right? So it is found that it is maximum in solid state. You'll get one mark a question definitely from here, students, okay? Hydrogen bonding is maximum in, we should remember that, it is maximum in solid state and minimum in a gaseous state, right? Thus hydrogen bonds have a strong influence on the structure and the properties of the compounds. In the next part we are going to learn the types of hydrogen bonding. There are two types of hydrogen bonding. The first one is intermolecular hydrogen bond. Inter means between the molecules, right? And the second one is intra. Intra means within the molecule. Is it clear, students? I make it once again clear. Inter means between two atoms, right? Intra means within the molecule. Now, intermolecular hydrogen bond, it is formed between two different molecules of the same or different compounds. For example, HF or H hydrogen bond in the case of HF molecule or alcohol or water molecules. And the second one is intramolecular hydrogen bond. As I have already told you, it is within the molecule. It is formed when hydrogen atom is in between two highly electronegative atoms present within the same molecule. For example, orthonitrophenol. So this is the structure of orthonitrophenol. So if I write here, so this is called as phenol. Okay, I write it as O and this I write it as H. Okay, this is phenol. And at ortho position, so this is called as ortho position. Okay, so here I am having the NO2 group. Okay, N double bond O and a dative bond O minus. Okay, which is called as what? O minus, dative bond. You can see that electronegative atom oxygen and electropositive element hydrogen, which are present within the molecule, so therefore hydrogen bond is formed here. So such type of hydrogen bonding is called as intramolecular hydrogen bond. Is it clear, students? Thank you for watching this video.